You guys might want to stand back. This can get a little
this is awesome.
Messy.
Oh.
Wow.
Ooh.
Oh my. That's wow. Fantastic.
Yeah.
I'm Allison Snell.
And I'm Colt Neidhart.
And we love craft beer. This is Good Life, Great Beer.
Hey y'all, welcome to Good Life, Great Beer. Today, Allison and I are making the first stop on our brewery tour across Nebraska. We are in the state's capital, Lincoln, and we are at White Elm Brewing.
White Elm Brewing has two locations in Lincoln, one in historic Haymarket, as well as south side of Lincoln, where we're at now in their main brewing facility.
So we're gonna go inside, sample a couple of beers, and interview head brewer Kolby Wood. Come with us.
How we doing, guys?
Allison,
I'm Kolby.
Nice
good to meet you.
Kolby.
Colt, great to meet you.
Nice to meet you, Kolby. All right.
Shall we?
Let's do this. I want to try the Fluffernutterdis, please.
Absolutely.
I'd like to try the Trivial and Sublime Fruit IPA.
You got it. All right.
Oh, beautiful.
Cheers, awesome. Guys.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Cheers.
So where does White Elm Brewing get its name from?
The house that we originally moved to has an enormous White Elm right in the front. One day the city arborist came by and kind of told us this is one of the last American elms or White Elms that has survived from Dutch elm disease. And it was nearly 100 years old. It really kind of drew back to the roots of Lincoln as it was expanding on the south side, kind of where we're at. And so it seemed like a fitting name. You know, we sat out on that front porch while we were working on the house and drank a lot of beers after we got done with work for the day. And it seemed like a fitting tribute.
So I hear you've got some work that we can help you doing.
Absolutely. So I was teasing when I started, you're not going to get stuck doing cellar work. We're not going to have you guys playing with dangerous chemicals. We're actually going to do some barrel sampling. So we've got a single barrel program that goes into some retailers who have brought back single barrels of bourbon for us to age stout in. We've got a couple that are nearing the 2 year in the barrel mark. And so we'll kind of go through, do a little bit of panel on them, see if they're ready to harvest.
Awesome.
I guess you can twist my arm.
Yeah, absolutely. I want to pause on the brewery action for a quick second to talk about our partner who made season one of Good Life, Great Beer possible. Now, as you're out visiting breweries and retail locations across the state, you may notice this little sign. Now, this sign lets you know that this business is a Nebraska Craft Brewers Guild member. Now, the Guild is a professional organization that promotes and protects the craft brewing industry in Nebraska. Your support of the Guild helps small businesses across our state. It helps create positive economic and social impact in our communities, and it creates jobs. Now, you can learn more about the Guild, locate Nebraska breweries, or become a Nebraska Beer Alliance member by visiting them online at nebraska.beer. All right, now we're back in White Elm's production facility, and we are with Kolby. We're gonna be doing some barrel samples on some different beers.
So we've got two today. We've got a 1792 full proof barrel that is setting right at 17 months. And then we've got a Buffalo Trace 8 year single barrel that's getting pretty darn close to ticking its second year. I think we're about 19 months on that. So we'll give a little sanitizer spray and pop the nails out of these and see how we're doing. You guys might want to stand back. This can get a little
this is all
messy.
Done. Oh.
Wow.
Woo. All right. Now I might ask one of you guys to grab this glass from me once I put this nail back in. All right. All right, so we'll start with that.
It's a drink and a show.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. There you guys go.
Thank you so much. These
more longer term agings are a lot of fun for us. There's a ton of prep work in getting the barrels ready and able to be in physical condition to hold beer for 2 years without getting overly oxidized where it goes straight sherry bomb. We want to pull these kind of lovely bourbon notes of coconut and vanilla and in soft oak with almost this like umami earthiness that comes from a year and a half of micro oxidation.
Do you recommend the swirl, the smell?
I have no idea, to be honest.
Do whatever feels good.
It's all a hedonistic pursuit here. You know, we typically will taste it when we're doing larger harvests where we have 8 to 10 barrels coming out. We'll say, hey, all of these are ready. We think in balance, maybe we should pull this one because it's expressing this more than we want. With these, it's a single barrel. So they are what they are. They're ready or they're not.
Yeah.
Oh my, that's fantastic.
Yeah.
So what notes change the most when you take a beer and put it in a barrel for aging?
Well, the first thing, about 2 months in, you really start drawing the base spirit, and the beer actually feels hot and a little bit more thin, and it'll taste like almost like a Boilermaker, you know, like it's like pouring a shot of whiskey into a beer. As it develops with time, about 8 months, you start pulling some like soft vanilla notes out of it as well. The alcohol presence sort of reduces. Around a year, it almost goes coconutty. When you get on the backside of that year, you start getting this where there's just subtle soft notes of sherry, more chocolate. There's definitely bourbon in there, but it's softer and it's lighter. And there's this kind of intertwined vanilla, coconut, chocolate thing. And I always say it's umami. It's that earthy, there is like an earthiness to it that extended aging brings out. Mm-hmm. And to me, it's one of the more desirable characteristics in one of these beers.
Yeah, this is absolutely umami bomb.
You get all the way around, you almost get like a soy flavor, sweet, everything. It's delicious. What would you say that makes White Elm unique in the world of Nebraska craft beers?
That's a good question. I think the variety in package, the availability of different types of beer. We're releasing around 10 beers a month, all of them going into package. So I think that's definitely a big part of it. I think that we're one of, a handful of breweries who are doing a lot of focusing a lot more on the barrel projects, things like that. And I say that with us still having definitely a reverence for the classic styles. So
our thanks to Kolby and everyone here at White Elm Brewing. These are absolutely fantastic and complex beers. I fell in love with a barrel-aged stout today. How about you?
I love all the beer, but I mostly love the atmosphere. That was a good time, wasn't it?
Yeah, an absolute blast. So we are on to our next brewery, and we're going to find out what other shenanigans we can get into.
Got it.
All right.